You guys know that these are the three kings. What happened? Self-proclaimed. We have Tully Kennedy on bass, Kurt Allison on guitar. We've been playing music together for 20 years.
That's a bump.
That's, yeah.
We're still learning the buttons.
But where's the audience? There it is.
Based on our history together. I know you're a big
based Adam. On our history.
Based.
This is a dirt. The real dirt.
Is a genre or genre?
It's genre.
Genre.
Is it genre? It's crazy. Ooh. Go genre. Ooh. Okay, here's a good topic. Guilty pleasures.
I want a cookies and cream blizzard.
You're going food.
Yeah. If we're talking about nothing.
I mean, that's usually what we are talking about.
Yeah. You know, when did everything start to mesh?
It meshed pretty instantly.
Well, we played together, mm-hmm. and you guys played together, and then we said, oh, you know him? Oh, you know him? And then you brought me in on the Amy Dell, and that's when we all came in together.
Yeah, and the meshing was instantaneous.
Yes, what was going to be plan B?
There was no.
Oh, yeah, no plan B.
There was no plan
That's
B.
That's part of the.
Still is no plan B.
There's always there's got to be something.
There was no plan B.
Well, Kurt went to audiovisual media training school for a while, right, to work at the TV station and do like graphics and voiceovers and stuff.
Oh, really?
And Tully has just been, he ran the band's light, drove the milk truck. He's been playing bass. Like, there was no back, there was no plan.
There was no plan. It was
ever.
Maybe that's the positive thing about moving here so young, you know, that. There was no plan B. He was going to play music and met these guys, and that turned out the destiny was already there in place. I've been very lucky to have my best friend, but create this musical core that we never had to stray from. Yeah, I did a lot of bad gigs when I first moved here.
But you didn't work day jobs either. I was the one that was always getting up and doing day gigs.
We're more visionaries, though. I think we kind of set ourselves apart. No, kidding. You know, if you could sing and play bass, you could work. And that you could, it's still that way. Like drummers,
a lot of drummers.
But guitar players, there wasn't a guitar player like Kurt is in town. A lot of country guys. But this is a different time. You got to remember, this is. You know, mid to late 90s, where it was a lot of drummer. I mean, everybody was a drummer. Everybody.
It seems like still is.
And the timing is crucial, and it all comes together, and it doesn't for some people, unfortunately. A lot of great people who are talented, and timing can be strange. You
know? Well, looking at the Crash Course philosophy, it couldn't have come together more perfectly than that acronym. For anything.
We made a commitment to stay together. We made a commitment to the artists that we were working with. We honored our relationships. We brought out the best in other people through our relationships with them. We always had a great attitude as far as when it came with like making it easy for people to work with us and making it a joyful experience. We had enough skill together, you know, you could put anybody in front of us that had like zero experience, karaoke singers who got signed to record deals, and we would make them sound like they were like seasoned. And then all these years later, we still have a hunger to be successful, you know.
But back then you were really hungry.
Yeah. Very hungry.
And I don't, you know, it wasn't like it was a self-help book for us at that time, obviously.
Yeah.
We can apply those principles to stuff now, but at that time it was desperation and passion, maybe those two things. I mean, we were desperate to work, and we were passionate about music and each other, and that really just did it for us. We were in Hicktown.
That was a 10-hour shoot in the mud pit with fires and trucks and
girls.
A lot of girls.
ATVs. Real country life right there.
Apparently.
Happens every weekend.
Yeah. And it was not glamorous, because after that video, I was like, there's got to be a party somewhere. We got to go do something and celebrate this 12-hour video shoot that we did.
Let's tear down your
ghost
beard.
Town. You know, let's face it, not a lot of people can say that they've had 3 number one songs with a Tasmanian pop country band. But you guys, did it seem real? You're like, oh my God, I'm in the songwriting capital of the world, and I'm a number one songwriter.
It doesn't hit me like that.
We don't look back on any of that. It's all what is happening today and what's going to happen tomorrow, because if you aren't thinking that way, you're going to get left in the past.
What was that place where we would play, we'd break our gear down, go out to the taco truck, and then a gigantic salsa orchestra would come in.
The homemade guacamole.
Or they come in with the
amazing guacamole.
The salsa band right after.
Yeah.
Subscribe, rate, and follow along at richredmond.com/podcasts.